Hello, Flosstube. We're the real housewives of cross stitch.
I'm Priscilla.
And I'm Chelsea.
This is Ronnie.
And Piper.
And we're here to talk to you about our stitching this week.
In news here, so I'm gonna just adjust this a little bit so you can see evenly. I thought it was even, it wasn't. In news, you see now social media has allowed that there is a new dog on campus named Sam, a rescue. Tanner and Bonnie rescued Sam. He's a boy. He is the most chill dog we've ever seen. He 3 years old?
Mm-hmm.
So he's 3 years old. He was surrendered by his owners, all that.
Yeah.
So he's fitting in very nicely. Okay, now we can let everyone know. All right, so not everyone in the household knew that Sam was coming to live here. So until everyone was notified, we had to keep it off social media. Mom didn't even know. Okay, so we had lots of questions last week. Thank you so much for all of your comments. Somebody was like, I was trying to leave a comment, but then scrolling through all of them, you read a lot of comments. There, I love
reading. How many
was there? 1,700.
Yeah, the last time I looked, there was 16-something.
Yeah, it's my favorite thing to do. Okay, so
and let's... thank you for all the happy birthday comments on there.
Mm-hmm. Happy birthday, and then all of the comments loving Holly Jolly Farm. Mm-hmm. Mom absolutely loves it. Her and Kathy mm-hmm. did a great job this time.
Mm-hmm. This time?
Well, no, I don't mean that. I mean, like, you know what I mean? It's a new favorite.
I love it because it's Christmas.
Right. And Buffalo Trek, and mm-hmm. just, it's, I'm Santa looking, it's right up here.
Who's down here?
Oh. No. Nala's down here. All right, so let's get into the questions. Chelsea, do you ever lace the backs of your pieces?
She doesn't finish anything.
No, sorry. Chelsea was the person asking.
Oh.
No, I know.
I was like, what?
No, we have no problems using sticky boards, so mm-hmm. that's what we do.
Although, when I do the whirly gigs, the circle ones, when I do a circle ornament finish too, I do
you'll
use
see those
needle
today.
And thread.
Yeah, so you'll see those today, and that's mm-hmm. a lacing mm-hmm. of a type, yeah.
You should see the table.
The table, and it's spilled
and
out
it's,
onto
yes,
the floor.
It's all the way to the kitchen.
Kids, just stay in there.
Yeah.
Leslie, have you ever have you ever reversed the order of dyeing fabric, then tea-dyeing? So have you ever tea-dyed the fabric and then slapped it in the writ dye?
Well, that might have been done because I didn't like it after it was
dyed,
and then I dyed it again and
but
so
never
yes.
purpose
yeah
never purposely
well,
started out
purpose, but yeah
started
not
out.
That wasn't the plan.
Kathy, I would love your a lot of people actually they want the stuffed artichokes recipe and they want the chicken pot pie recipe.
Okay,
so chicken pot pie isn't our recipe, but I can definitely like link it below. Mm-hmm. I can do that today. And then did you make the artichokes or they're bad enough?
No, I never made them. They're still in the refrigerator.
We might be making gnocchi today.
I forgot
gnocchi.
All about them.
And
we've never had gnocchi before.
Never. So. We're going to try it. All right. Good thing is we won't know if they're made right because we've never tasted it to know the difference. So if you wanted to know, she says, Chelsea says Priscilla always went all out for Christmas gifts. And she's wondering if I'm the same way or how you manage gifts for the kids. I've heard of something you want, something you need, something you wear, and something you read. I've heard about that too. Do you spend the same dollar amount or do you get the same amount of gifts?
I do same dollar amount.
So I always try to, you know, we try to make it even. I will say that on Christmas morning, I don't let the kids like open one at a time because I never want somebody to feel left out. So it's just kind of a free for all, which makes it harder for like pictures and things like that. But I just don't want it to be like people are counting because as kids get older, electronic gifts are what you gravitate more towards, and those are more expensive. So, I mean, it's difficult. I will say I'm fortunate enough to provide a magical Christmas for my kids every year, which is something that I'm really grateful for. So,
it's hard.
It is.
Santa needs to step it up.
we try to find a lot of things on sale. I have tried to start early this year, so I've started now. Just me being early instead of like the week of.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, but they do get all of those things. They get like pajamas and clothes and books. Like those are all included in their gifts.
Mm-hmm.
And if you stop believing in Santa Claus, then you get socks and underwear.
That's right.
Okay, and that's the same here.
Thank you for all of you that are showing your selfies with your sweatshirts. Oh,
yes,
I love it.
We love them. We love them.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of questions about true to size. We said it last week. So they are true to size, but if you enjoy your sweatshirts, like some people wear a hoodie as over a bunch of layers, or they like them like to be comfier.
But they are stretchy. They're really like stretchy.
Right. I said last, they're not crisp. Like they're
knit. They stretch.
Yeah.
It's more like a sweater feel to me, the way that it stretches so much than.
And I enjoy this.
Yeah,
fit.
I think that this is my fourth or fifth time wearing.
just slap it on. I didn't want to get dog hair all over it, so I haven't been wearing it as much as I thought I would. But I definitely wore it to the basketball tournament on Saturday, and I was kids. Oh my god. Okay, Diana, can you show or explain how you do a covered button? So I think that's perfect. So we're thinking about we're kind of gathering a list of mm-hmm. tutorials that we want to do possibly
we're going
with
the
back quarter. So if you have ideas, please be sure to list them in the comment section below, and we can kind of create a whole list mm-hmm. of things that you're interested
in. Right now, we're compiling our list of videos and also the dates that we can go because we do have retreats and things that we have to plan for too.
So we're figuring that all out. All right, Mary, how do I get the chicken joy chart everyone is stitching?
It's on my blog.
On the blog, so I can link that again below. It might have been linked last week too, chicken joy. So
Priscilla's2000.blogspot.com.
And then from there you can search chicken mm-hmm. joy.
You can look in the side too. There's a
sidebar.
Yeah. Was that in October where you did that?
Yeah. Carolyn, what size magnets do you use?
They're about an inch probably, or 3/4 of an inch.
Yeah. We do not use the rare earth magnets.
No.
Most of the time we get our magnets.
They're ceramic.
On at Home Depot or Menards, any
or Amazon too.
Yeah, so people were asking in our shop. I haven't put them in our shop because we were trying them.
You bought those ones.
I bought them. Okay.
But the washers were not good.
All right. So what I was doing was testing what we bought first.
That was like months ago. So.
I know. We just forgot. So I have to find new washers.
We've been kind of busy.
We're not even. I feel like I'm spinning my wheels. We're getting a bunch of stuff done, but not. Staying, there's a lot, you know, you want to decorate. I got a toddler that is teething all of his teeth at once. So there's just, and I ran outside to the chicken coop yesterday. I come in, he's standing up on the coffee table. Yeah, the coffee table, standing on the coffee table like this. Get out! Just like 5 seconds, literally, it was 5 seconds to go check on the chickens. And he's standing and dancing on the freaking coffee table. I'm going to lose my mind. All right, anyways.
Sure.
That was rude. I get it from you. Mm-hmm. All right, Lori, what's on your menu for Thanksgiving?
Well, that's a good question. We've been talking about that.
I don't know, Lori.
Definitely turkey. You got to get it out of the freezer and put it in the refrigerator for me.
Okay.
I already bought a 26-pound.
Great reminder. So we get a big turkey. Mm-hmm. We have decided. So there were so many comments.
Yeah,
either way, we're not going to fry it. So it is dangerous.
We don't have an emergency room.
Right. It is dangerous. You have to have somebody to watch it. So they're like, mm-hmm. oh, it's a great idea for their husbands or brothers. So their idea of a happy Thanksgiving is laying on the couch until it's time to eat. They remove their
football in the front yard.
Right. They remove themselves from the couch, sit down to eat, and then go back to the couch. So them standing outside and watching probably wouldn't be in there.
No.
So we're just, but people said it was really good.
Mm-hmm. Some people said that they didn't like it though, so.
Right. They said it was really moist. And so there was another comment that I kind of related to. I like a dry turkey. I like the dry, shriveled pieces of turkey. I don't know. I'm the minority. I understand that. But and somebody said she wraps it in bacon, and that sounded delicious.
I didn't want to deal with all that oil, too.
Yep.
So.
Okay. Cheryl, what's your pot pie recipe? I'm going to link it. Cindy, how many hours do you have in on the new farm? Yeah. How many days did that take you, let's say?
Well, it depends, because I feel like I stitched all of it twice.
She had to rip out so much. And then she was just trying to calculate math to fudge it a little bit.
Yes, because I added 2 extra stitches up on that top swirly border on the big piece. And I was all the way down and had so much of it done that I could, so I had to like do math to figure out where how to make it the bottom 2 parts even, and
it still looks good. It's mm-hmm. okay.
Yeah, nobody.
That's a
nobody
perfect example
know.
Of
nobody
hey,
would know
if you
if
have
I
an
didn't
extra,
tell you,
right?
So.
Right. Okay, Jane.
But I was having a heart attack. But it like the little sign would probably take you 2 days if you could stitch a lot. The little tiny piece, a couple hours.
Yeah. Jane wanted to know, Chelsea, how do you like your new car? Hubby is thinking of ordering a fully loaded in the spring. So I too have the fully loaded SX. I love it. It's very nice. I will say that I'm getting a lot of people at night flashing their brights at me, and then it was foggy the other day and I had a guy flip me off because the lights are so bright and like the I looked on the forums. They can't be adjusted. The reflection for the people, they think your brights are on. So it's like, I feel bad every time I drive.
Just don't drive at
night if you get it. Right. I feel guilty. I'm like, but you can see everything. Like, I can see the world when I'm driving.
It's good. Then you don't hit a deer.
Right. But I absolutely love it. It drives really nice. It vibrates if you go over the lane. Like, there's so many things that it does.
For her astigmatism.
Right. The thing beeps nonstop. Just beep, beep, beep,
see,
beep.
I was right.
It has the heated steering wheel, the heated seats. The only thing that it doesn't have, and when I was talking to the guy, I'm like, it's going to have everything that my Jeep has, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't have push button start on the remote. So they say you can go through an app, but I can't get the app downloaded. And I always like to start my car in the mornings, or if I'm in the store in the parking lot, I always like to have it warm for the kids. And it doesn't have that. You'd think being top of the line, it would have that, but it doesn't.
I'm gonna have to suffer.
Anyways, I like the car. It's nice. Great gas mileage. Two sunroofs. Beautiful. The kids aren't fighting because somebody's sitting on each other and somebody's touching me. And they're not fighting. Everybody's separated. Everybody has their own space. So it's nice. Okay. Anyways, not that that ever happens. All right, Elizabeth. Could Fat Quarter Shop offer the farmhouse chalk as a package?
Yes, they're kidding it up. I heard that yesterday. Because they asked me to send mine.
She's like, it's too big.
And I'm like, it's too big. I can't.
Shelby, how mobile is Cash? Is he getting into all of the Christmas decor? Mm-hmm. He is running. Mm-hmm. He's running. He is extremely mobile.
He doesn't really touch my stuff, though.
No. And he doesn't at home. He says, wow, when I light up the tree. But that's about it. The other day he was running around with an ornament, but we put it back and he was okay. He understood, but he's more into just like, if I'm unloading the dishwasher, he's got to hand me everything that, like, one at a time. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, it makes your chores 10 times longer, but it's adorable. So yes, he's into everything. All right. Joe, are you sending your things off to a quilter? Or are you quilting yourself? Well, we're a do-it-yourselfer kind of person.
Yep. I finished my quilt, though.
She was, like, this far from the end, and the needle breaks, and she had no more.
Yeah, so I had to run to the store.
Okay. Kieran, how do you do the back stitching on the Chicken Joy chart?
Back stitching?
Yep, for the light strand.
Oh, you did it, like, long stitches, didn't you, and then tacked it down? No? Yeah. I don't even remember. It's been so long.
It's a light strand.
Is mine right behind you?
Yeah, but it's got stuff on it.
Okay. Is the stitches long, or did I do each back stitch separately?
Long.
Okay, so I just went from point to point, like from, you know, the X's that are supposed to be the lights, just go from there to the next one.
Sometimes you have to,
like, it's called couching, where you come up like halfway through and just do a little stitch over the top of the thread that you put if you think it doesn't look right. You can Google that and
Google
see what couching is.
I would Google that. Okay. Here we go. Cheryl. Totally messed up while finishing with sticky board. I forgot that I had to fold the edges over, and I rotary cut the edges off. Should I restitch it? Leave it alone? What should I do? Make it work. Not restitch it.
So if you can fit, if it's like a regular size and you can fit it into a regular picture frame, nobody would know the difference.
Right.
Or
attach a ruffle on the edges.
Right. Or even a ribbon around the edges or something.
Yeah.
I would not restitch it.
No. We'd just make it work.
Mm-hmm.
Georgette, I love your shirts. How can I order? There is a link in the description box below for mm-hmm. our t-shirts and for our sweatshirts. They are provided to us through fatquartershop.com.
So you can also Google Fat Quarter Shop and then Stitching with the Housewives. And we have like a page of merchandise
right.
and stuff, but their search function is not working the best right now, so sometimes it works perfectly and other times, like this morning, I had to search for something and it came right up. So
and sometimes you have to use quotation marks when you're using the search field, so they're doing ongoing maintenance. Mm-hmm. And it should be complete
in a week.
Yeah, in a week. All right, Peggy, I love the new farm. Where did you get the barn door to put it on?
I bought that at Hobby Lobby in the spring, though, so it's probably not available anymore.
Janae wanted to know what your favorite brand and size needle is.
Pat Carson 26.
So we stitch on 28 count, which is also like a 14 count. So we use a size 26 needle. If you're stitching on different fabric counts, you'll want to adjust your size needle. We have found the Pat Carsons are better. They don't bend. I won't say they don't bend. They don't bend as easy.
If you do Ada 14, you use a 24 needle.
Oh, okay. But you'll want to adjust your needle size.
So the reason why I like Pat Carson is, first of all, they're smooth. There's never any burrs. Second of all, the hole that you stick your thread in is bigger than any of the other ones. Bowhen is my second choice.
Favorite. I like the, as my second choice is the ballpoint, ball tip needles. But you can.
I've never tried one of those.
Yep. They're like a little bit longer, I would think. Mm-hmm. But if you have skin issues, so I have a lot of, especially in the winter, I have a lot of like dry skin and it gets irritated by sewing. So those Pat Carson needles, I've never had an issue with. Rachel, being from the UK, I haven't heard of frying a turkey. Do you take it apart? Do you fry whole? How big is this fryer? They just dunk it in.
It's like you fry 12-pound turkeys, I think, or 14 mm-hmm. pounds.
You have to dry it off first because if you don't, it could be like...
It could explode.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's...
It's scary.
There's a lot of bad
Somebody
things.
Said they put the dad put the fryer on the kitchen table, and when they came home, it had burned a hole through the kitchen table, and it was on the ground. Like it's yeah. Somebody said that's the number
you
one
do it
right. The number one reason why
Don't
firefighters
fry a turkey in the house.
Firefighters are called on Thanksgiving is because of the fried turkey. We just don't have people responsible enough to do that in our house, including us. I'm not, no thank you.
Yeah, we're lucky we can cook the turkey in the oven.
Paula, do you plant anything as a fall garden? I planted some radishes and things like that are still in there. And I've kept my carrots in the ground and I just pulled a couple the other day to make,
Don't they get sweeter when it gets cold?
Yeah, so after that frost, they get sweeter.
I have nothing.
Like Brussels, too. Brussels
I have nothing.
I plan to do more fall gardening next year.
Well, this year was kind of not opportune, though, with a snowfall.
Right. On Halloween.
Measurable inches in October.
That a day before Halloween. And last year was, this year was all about building my boxes and figuring out where everything went, and that was my focus. So coming next year, I want to build, like, some hoops that I can take off during the summer months and put on during fall. I want to be able to be harvesting
more.
Something. Yeah. Throughout the winter.
Just whack me with your hair again.
It's shorter though, so it didn't hurt as bad. Debbie just got seasons in chalk. This is a really good question. Christmas. And she's wondering if you stitched it now, what would your classic color works be? Obviously licorice red and chalk you would still use, but what would your...
My green be?
Yeah, green.
I might do the holly jolly.
Oh.
Jolly holly. Jolly. I might do that to make it more...
What other colors current. Are in there? Is there a brown?
There's a tan. I would probably change it to gray.
Do
you know that? That's
playing.
A cat.
All right.
It's in his catnip.
Priscilla, Patricia wants to know, have you heard of the Garden Answer YouTube? I think you'd love it.
Yes.
Yeah, we do.
I'm like your biggest fan.
Laura! Laura did this, so we have to do it.
Oh.
Did you see what she did? And Patricia put that she's thinking about putting air conditioning in her chicken coop. I hadn't seen that. Chickens don't need air conditioning. Chickens do not need air conditioning.
They live in 100-degree weather, though.
Chickens do not need air conditioning.
Okay, next question.
Did you see chickens when you were in Hawaii? Just running around?
No, but in the Bahamas.
But, okay, did they need air conditioning?
And every place else I took pictures
right.
of. I didn't see any in Hawaii, but we didn't really go.
Did the chickens you saw in the south have air conditioning?
Maybe they did. I don't know.
Oh, my God. I
didn't follow them home.
They don't need air conditioning. They're fine. I love my chickens, but I'm not giving them air conditioning. Okay, Regina, on average, how many charms do you have on each bracelet? As many as will fit.
A lot.
We don't even want to count. We don't want to think about it. We just love them. Oh, I need another bracelet. To be honest, I have 5 charms that I need another bracelet for. So I'm waiting because during Christmas time, they say if you spend this much, you get a free bracelet. So I'm waiting. All right, Maribeth. Are you willing to share the artichoke recipe? Oh, yep, we will. Nikki, do either of you Black Friday shop in store or do you just look online? We try to go to Walmart.
So last year we didn't go, but the year before we went to Walmart and we did get some really good buys.
Yep.
And then
you got a vacuum.
The year before that, it's like we always buy one of those electric griddles because we wear them out.
Yep. Other than the griddles and the Walmarts, I don't know that we go anywhere.
We went to Kohl's one time too.
Yeah.
And I don't know, did we do any shopping online?
It scares me, honestly, to go. We were talking about going out this year, but it does, like...
But we don't go, like, late at night or anything.
No. It just worries me. Because people are crazy.
When she worked for Verizon, she worked in a kiosk in the mall.
Oh, my God.
There was, like...
There was a riot. They had to shut...
they were ducking down underneath the kiosk. It was bad.
It was, an overnight thing that I had to do, and, people were picking up trash cans and the stores were shutting their gates because there were messages about people running around with knives and guns. So they were shutting their gates and they were taking the trash cans and slamming them up against the metal gates. Like, I was ducked down on the floor and my manager, she was Latina and she was really like firecracker. She was up on the counter in heels, like screaming at people. Like, I was terrified. I was like, I want my mom. I don't get paid enough for this. So they didn't do it after that. So thank God they don't do that anymore. But it's just traumatizing.
And it's not like we live in a bad neighborhood.
No, it was just like people, there was a shoe store across the thing that they're throwing the garbage cans at trying to get shoes for Black Friday splash. There's not enough savings that I could have for that. Maybe if I live near Disney, then I would be Black Friday shopping. All right, will you do Flosstube next week because of the holiday?
Yeah.
Of course. I had a baby and I did a Flosstube. Of course. All right, Tammy, can you do a video showing the picks and the bows and wreath-like, the embellishments?
Yeah,
that's a good idea.
That's all going to be with backorder.
Kirstie, I think Cash is copying Grandma's hairstyle last week with this little fuss up here. All right, Stacy, how much extra fabric do you allow for finishing? She's read about 3 inches, but she thinks that seems like a lot.
I do, like, between an inch and 2 inches.
Yeah.
There's five kids in the other room if you're having to deal with a lot of noise. Sorry.
I leave like a quarter inch, you know, just to make her work for it. Just kidding. Leave enough room. It's better to have too much room.
3 inches is a lot.
Yeah. But if you're taking it to a professional framer, that's what they want.
I thought it was 2. Mm.
Christine, would you do a finishing class closer to where you live, Northern Illinois?
We could. We've talked about trying to do our own retreat, but we haven't set anything in motion yet. So, unless somebody wants to step in and organize it,
slow the rain, sir.
All right, we were thinking farm girls should put one on close.
Suzanne, okay, so I left this question for last because I'm gonna probably go off on a tangent for it. So if you're not interested in this, you can kind of skip forward to next part, and the next part will be. Oh, also, I want to say. Sorry for all the car dealers and lawyers for last week. It wasn't meant to be bad. All I meant was that when I go into a car dealership, I get really sweaty. That's an exorbitant amount of money that I'm about to spend, and I just feel like I'm not getting a good discount.
Yeah, you never know if you're getting a good deal.
Right. There was one time when I was first buying my Jeep, and he wrote down a bunch of numbers, but he was telling me different numbers, and I didn't realize it until I got home and looked at my paper, and there was discrepancies. So that man ruined it for everything. All right, but... All I'm saying is that I get sweaty.
We love car dealers and lawyers.
We do love lawyers, just not that particular lawyer that was a jerk, okay? All right, anyways. Suzanne, our family is going to Disney World next October. What do you recommend not to miss? We haven't been for 7 years. Should we do the fast passes? There's 9 of us. Is that even going to work with fast passes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. When we went for my wedding, there was a bunch of us, mm-hmm. 2 different families. Well, 3 different families. So we had 3 different fast pass reservation things. So if that's the case, then you kind of have to get together and make your fast passes around the same time because then, but yes, you want to do the fast passes.
Unless everybody wants to ride totally different stuff. And
right. But if you're going, you probably want to go I wanted to go as a family. So I wanted everybody to be together. If you're all on the same reservation, you'll be able to make the same fast passes. Now my usual thing for fast passes is my strategy is I usually set them for right in the morning, which I have read is dumb because the rides aren't really full right in the morning. So you should do it during the afternoon, when people are actually riding the rides. I don't know how true that is. So I have one coming up. I can't say it very loud because they don't know. That I'm going to try putting my fast passes towards the afternoon. Things that you shouldn't miss, obviously, are the new attractions. So you haven't been there for 7 years, so that's a long time. That's Toy Story Land. That's Star Wars Land. I call it Star Wars Land. I know that's not what it's called.
Galaxy's Edge?
Mine Train hasn't been there. Yeah, Galaxy's Edge, I think. Pandora.
I would do the Mickey's not-so-scary Halloween party.
Yeah, so one of your nights.
So you can see the Halloween parade.
Yeah, do they have two parades? Or just one for that?
They don't have a regular Halloween parade. The only way you can see the Halloween parade is if you go to the party.
Right, but I read for the Christmas party they have two parades during the party. So parades. And then you have a special fireworks show.
Mm-hmm.
What else? I would just say also you're going to want dining reservations. So that is something that is kind of new within 7 years, where you're going to want to plan out at least some of the bigger dinners. Like, I know we always plan out our Chef Mickey's, our Mama Melrose's, because those things fill up and you can't just like walk in, right?
Okay, so my advice to you is to go to Disney Food Blog, DFB Guide, on YouTube, and search for their Halloween videos and also their best restaurants, their best, they give you everything that you need to know.
Yep.
Just search their list of videos. They're great.
Also, I listened to a podcast, Unlocking the Magic, and that's a husband and wife, and they just kind of go through different Disney things, and they also kind of go through the history of some of the rides, which is interesting. It's when you're on Flosstube, your nose itches. I would just say plan a little bit. Don't over plan it, but make sure that your fast passes line up so you're not here, then there, then here. Mm-hmm. Plan out your trip accordingly. Mm-hmm. We are the type that don't take breaks. We go from sun up to sun down. Mm-hmm. If your party's not able to do that, don't push yourselves, because you're going to hate the vacation. What else? What else not to miss? Mama Melrose's is in Hollywood Studios. That's a really good Italian, like, grandma's kitchen.
I didn't
love
it this time when I went. Get the chicken and waffle sandwich at...
So there's at Sleepy Hollow.
Castle. Yeah.
Sleepy Hollow.
It's just a little stand.
They have either a Nutella and fruit... waffle burrito thing, or they have a chicken and waffles, and that has a spicy coleslaw. Is that true? And it's very good. Very good. What else?
The cinnamon rolls at the Starbucks. Amazing.
Animal Kingdom Starbucks. And where else did you get them?
They didn't. Epcot Starbucks was closed when we were there. There's no Starbucks in Epcot.
Okay. The other thing, in 2021, I was thinking about it, in October, you're not going to be able to go.
Why?
Unless you want to fight all the crowds, because it's their 50th anniversary.
Yeah, but that lasts all year, because we went for the 25th. Don't you remember? We have all the pictures with the cake that was covered in the
Does it start January 2021, or does it start in October? Anyway.
Well, whatever. It'll last for a year.
But their anniversary is in October of 2021.
Yeah,
so.
I know.
What else? There is, by the Pirates of the Caribbean, I've heard that they have a food cart, and they have, what are they?
Egg rolls.
They have, like, seasonal egg rolls that are supposed to be really good, too.
Okay. Is that the last of the questions?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mom wants to get off of it.
People might not want to listen to that.
I know. That's why I said skip forward.
Okay. So for previous finishes, this is Country Cottage Needleworks. I think it is called Tis the Season, but was this the first one I finished on a cupcake pan? Or you don't remember?
I don't remember. This is a vintage mold.
Yeah, muffin pan, whatever. And I have magnets on there, so I change them out because I have like four different seasons.
If you see this chart, she's pink. They're pink.
Oh, right. They're pink. I changed them to red. Licorice red. And I used hickory sticks for the brown instead of using like the roasted chestnut or something. But that is on my blog probably 2 years ago if you want more information. And I just scratched my nose again. This is also Country Cottage Needleworks. This started a run on that truck at Walmart.
What's wonderful time of the year.
Most wonderful time of the year. Okay. And then I had two of these vintage cookie cutters from my childhood that are gingerbread men. I used a wreath that I found like at a thrift store or something, and the truck, and I added some flocked picks, some bows made out of homespun fabric, and then the two gingerbread, and it hangs on my basement door. I love it. Chelsea did that same one too, and I finished hers the same way, except for we didn't have the vintage cookie cutters. We used like
stuffed gingerbread men.
Do you want to share your one finish and then we'll show mine?
Yep. So this is the trivet finish. This is heart and hands.
Right.
What is it?
Whirligig.
Whirligig, sorry.
That's the autumn.
I was thinking the squared series, but I haven't done this month. So this is autumn.
And then mine is the winter one. I finished them both this week for us. And if you want to know how to finish the round circle, that is a video. It's either on our channel or the Fat Quarter Shop channel. It might be on our channel.
Did you change any of your colors?
Yes, I changed all the colors. It's on my blog.
Okay.
But I love it. I used that Lori Holt vintage trim in cayenne and then some white and red plaid around the edges.
In what?
Cayenne.
Oh, cayenne.
A couple of different ribbons for the bows, some flocked greenery, and then I did the cover button in plaid.
That's cute.
All right, and then I have two of Kimberly's finishes. This is Thistle and
Trellis and Thyme.
Oh my gosh, I wrote it wrong then on my blog. Sorry.
We'll edit that.
Trellis and Thyme. Trick or treat. And I had found this pumpkin at Hobby Lobby a few months ago. And her piece fit perfectly on it, so I used it for it. I made the bow out of three different ribbons, added some candy corn picks, and then I did the cover button with the cat again like I did on one of Chelsea's.
That's very cute.
Mm-hmm. I have to go change that. This is Kimberly's Chalkfull Mary. I found this frame at Hobby Lobby. It's a regular picture frame. I cut the sticky board to fit the inside of it, and I covered it in the red gingham. I mounted the stitching on sticky board and added that to the top, and then I did a bow of two different kinds of ribbon and then some really sparkly greenery with pine cones and a painted snowflake. I think it's so pretty. And this is on my blog today along with the Thistle and Thyme. Trellis and Thyme, sorry.
Thyme. Trellis and Thyme.
Sorry.
It's okay.
I gotta fix that. My big one down by you.
Oh, gosh.
Wait till you guys see this.
You're gonna be waiting. It's gonna take me a minute.
So, this is my glitter village. And remember, I said I was doing them, you know, separately. So, I stitched on this, like, all last year. I knew exactly what I wanted to do with it, and I think it turned out so pretty. So I added the two big greenery picks. There's lights in here. I don't know if you can see the lights. There's a deer. There's some bottle brush trees. And then I had this little putz type of house. It's a church, actually, that I added to the top. The lights are battery operated. I actually have it taped back here, the control thing. Yeah, it's bad. Backing tape. But I mounted each one on sticky board and added, it's like a gray little check. But this won't go out in my Christmas decorations. This is for winter for me, so you'll see it more then. But this will be on my blog tomorrow if you want any more details. I did use all the called for colors except for the glittery floss. I used tea and biscuits from Classic Colorworks. But I love the way it turned out, and I think, oh, and I added two aqua bows up here, and there's also some white sparkly picks. It's so pretty. So that was my big finish. All right, you want to show your whips?
Yeah, so this week I decided to pull out a bunch of Christmas whips. So I usually have my stuff separated into bags, but I put them into my Stitching with the Housewives bag. So I just take this with me everywhere now. I have a bunch of Christmas stuff that I can get done because that's probably what I'm going to be focused on the majority of the month. So this is one that I'm trying to finish up. I'm almost done. This is Country Cottage Needleworks Snow Love. So I've got just to finish her French knots, and then I'm done.
That's cute. Mm-hmm. Looks small.
It's an ornament.
I know, but it looks tiny. Like the stitches look tiny. That's my astigmatism.
Next up in my Sharon Snow bag. This is my Christmas alphabet.
She's gotten far.
Santa's face isn't done because I needed to find my perfect pie crust. This is Christmas Alphabet by Prairie Schooler. This is the stitch along that we're doing with Fat Quarter Shop. So remember that I'm just doing the banner. So I have C-H-R-I-S-T, and I've started the M down here.
You're just speeding through that. I decided how I'm finishing mine. I can't wait to get mine done.
So I will tell you why I'm able to speed through it is because we're only using a select amount of colors for it. And then I just slap them my rat's nest on here and I'm able to just kind of pull from them. So I'm not like digging and sorting and everything else. It's going very quickly. Like I can do one of these in like probably 2 car waits outside the school. For those of you that are following, you know, I get there early. Next up, I pulled out this one. This is Mary Mouse. I pulled this out because, truth be told, I had a mouse in the house. A couple mice. So we've got that under control now, but I decided to start stitching a mouse.
She bought 6 cats.
So this is With Thy Needle and Thread. And before, when I had it, I had 2 different leaf colors, and I asked you guys to vote on which one I should use. I had English Ivy and Holly, Jolly Holly on here. I ripped both of them out, and I'm using steamed broccoli on it, and I'm using licorice red down here. I also pulled out the color of the mouse, and I started using Wagon Wheel, and I did Wagon Wheel for him instead.
You ripped it all out?
Yep.
Wow.
So he's almost done. Kind of like the mice in my house. They're done. Next up, I pulled out this. I only put a few stitches in, but this is my biggie, and I decided that I needed to work on it. This is Santa's Village Country Cottage Needleworks. I'm on poinsettia place. You guys haven't seen this for a while, so I'll show you my first one, my first guy, and I did Santa's beard, fluffy and fun. And then here is poinsettia place.
I love Santa's Village.
Okay, so this was a huge piece. If I could do it all over again, I'd probably do them separately so that my brain...
I know. Didn't we already find your frame for that too?
Yes, it's in my craft room. Needle on the loose. Last but not least...
You worked on a lot too.
I needed to. I just
bring cute Grinch bag.
This is, and I folded my Prairie Schooler, and I should not do that. Don't be me. Prairie Schooler, Santa's 12 Days of Christmas, number 8 with the cow.
I kind of like the new printed Prairie Schoolers because I don't feel as guilty about it. The old ones, I feel
you have to it's vintage.
They're revered. Yeah.
Vintage. Okay. I don't know that I'm going to do all of the 12 Days of Christmas, so I don't know that I'm going to number them. I think I might just want Mom to make them into ornaments for my barn farm tree.
That's a good idea.
So, because I don't know that I'm in love with all of them enough to do them all, you know? And they are kind of big for me, for ornaments. Okay. All right. That's all I worked on.
Okay. So, I started this for Stitchmania, and I started it on like the gray coffee tea dyed fabric that we use, and I was using I wasn't using the coffer colors, I was using similar colors. And I took it back out and I started to stitch the word visit because all I had done was family, and I was like, why am I stitching this in blue? I don't want it to be blue, but I'm doing it on blue fabric. So I'm changing the colors, and oh my goodness, I love it. This is my Christmas list from Silver Creek Samplers. And this is fabric that has been dyed, I think, evening blue, right? Or denim blue. And then coffee tea dyed. So.
And it's Silver Creek Sampler is my list.
My Christmas list. I changed the color of the car to red instead of, and I'm using ribbon red on this. But I'm alternating the words and I can't wait to get more of it done.
I like that little sweater.
One more letter on the Christmas alphabet. I did this when I went to the laundromat this week. Finally got my comforters washed.
Okay, so another laundromat story. So last week they didn't have an ATM. This week she forgot her soap.
Yep.
So she had to come.
I had to go home and get my soap.
She's like, should I go home and get the soap and come back or go home and just go
because
home?
Because I don't like any other laundry soap besides that Purcell Pro Clean, the smell of it. So
she's very picky, very particular.
If you haven't used that Priscilla Pro Clean, it's like the top-rated detergent, and it's amazing, the smell of it. So we are changing the colors on this, too. We're using our
Be Merry Pack.
Be Merry Floss Pack, except for we used cocoa bean, right, on the...
You used cocoa bean, I used wagon wheel.
On the deer.
Yep.
Okay, and then... I did a little bit more on Celebrate Christmas.
Madame Chantilly, Celebrate Christmas.
I worked on the leaves.
Are you using the Mary Pack?
Yes. I'm using ribbon red on that one too. And this morning I started...
Oh my goodness.
So all I'm doing is the station wagon. I want it for an ornament and I'm using the 32 count checkerboard. What is that stuff called?
Fabric flare.
No. Is it? I don't think it is. It's available at Fat Quarter Shop.
We'll figure it out.
Mm-hmm. But it's 32 count and I did it.
What did you do?
What do you mean what did I do? And I love it because the stitches look really puffy.
Which way were you going? Oh, you were going this way? Hold tight.
She wants to see if she can do it. Anyway, also what I've been working on is in here, and I can't show you because it's the new jar.
Yeah, somebody asked what is jar stitching on her post. Jar stitching just means she's working on a new jar and she can't show you.
But I showed you the floss colors yesterday on my Instagram and my...
Oh my gosh, I would be able to do this.
Yep. And the fabric isn't bad.
It's kind of crunchy. I like it. All right, I'm going to order some of this when we're done. Remind me. I haven't worked on Lantern Lane either. I just realized because I ran out of the two most important colors that I need. So I'm going to make an order and then I'll get back to my PC.
I kind of think that this is cherry cobbler. It might be ribbon red, but I had a piece of it sitting on my, and I just wanted to see if I could do it. So I figured I would match it up later, but I could do it. So, but I, like I said, I'm just doing the station wagon because I want it for my, I have a tree that has nothing but trucks with,
yep,
trees in the back, and there's a couple station wagons and campers with trees on them, so I thought it would be cute for that. Mm-hmm. Chelsea found those.
Yeah, so half an hour from the school is a Home Goods and a TJ Maxx, and yesterday I didn't feel like going home. I have to do two pickups, one for sports and one not. So I was like, I'm just going to go see if they have anything. And they had a ton of stuff. And I was like, oh my goodness. It was packed though. Did I tell you that?
Mm-mm.
It was packed. But they had these two bowls. So I'm like FaceTiming mom and the little boys around them. What are you doing? Like just in Piper barking in the background. I'm like, oh my gosh, make her quiet because these people are looking at me. Anyway.
I have to say that Farm Girl showed a video on her Instagram list this week. And it was her dog going to the vet. And the dog was like howling the whole time. Piper sat there and watched the whole thing. She was so thrilled.
This was what you can't show?
No, I can show it. But so I plan on stitching, what's this one called?
Snow Village.
But I'm not starting it until after January because it's not Christmas to me.
And it's not going to
be done. And so January, this is going to be my start. But
it's
more
winter than Christmas for her, is what she's saying.
And I decorate with snowmen after Christmas. So January through like the middle of, or towards the end of February, is snowmen in the house instead of anything else.
Christmas.
And I don't decorate for Valentine's Day. It's all snowmen winter.
Mm-hmm.
But I have my bag and I'm just putting my charts in here. And this is the fabric I'm stitching it on. And I'm ready to go.
Sneaker peeker.
Mm-hmm. So I'm excited about that, and I am doing it all in one piece. So.
Mm-hmm. Is it going to replace your Santa's village then?
Maybe.
Wow.
Maybe. All right. Okay, so that's all I have. I did get some haul.
Oh, I ordered myself another Santa shirt.
Because I want to wear it all the time. And then this must have been in my cart from the last time I ordered because I got another one.
We share
and
the email. And
she texted me and she's like, why?
I was like, did you sit on it? Did you wreck it? What happened to it? Did you give it away? What happened to it?
I'm like, I didn't order that. So it'll be a giveaway today.
So then, another one of you gets to stitch along with us. Right. Trust me, these are like
they're small.
They're small, so you'll
you could definitely get that by Christmas.
You could get joy done, but if I you just get it late.
Bent Creek chart, I thought was really cute.
Oh, Bent Creek chart. Why are we ordering Halloween right now? It is.
I don't know. It's cute.
So this guy reminds me of the guy at when you're going up the hill on Splash
and
Mountain.
Sticky board.
Sticky board. I need to order you some sticky board.
Yes. So
sorry. One shirt Piper. My husband asked when he gets a hoodie, and I was
never. Everybody here asks all the time, when do we get hoodies?
Never.
Yeah. Place an order.
All right, what else we got? We had some giveaways.
And don't forget, we have our three packs, plus we have the Fancy Floss Favorites and the finishing packs at Fat Quarter Shop.
This was from Heather. We're going to go on to gifts. I know this video is getting pretty long. She wanted to send a few Christmas minders, she said.
Well, open yours. This one was mine. It looks like Ray Dunn.
I think you have mine.
Oh. It says Mrs. Claus, and the other one is a snowman. What's the name of her shop?
Crafty Girl from Jersey on Instagram, or she's the, on Etsy, she's Vintage Moose NJ. So I will make sure that I
link that. And she made us needle minders before that we showed you.
It says Jingle Bells and then a tree.
Cute.
In the Ray Dunn writing.
I like to have these on my
light.
Mm-hmm. To hold my charts.
Okay, there's that so you don't use it.
Those are actually her relatives.
Oh, wow. This is from Paula.
That's a cute idea for a card.
Yeah. Oh, it was a birthday.
Mm-hmm.
An actual picture of a great uncle and aunt, not me. It's just not me.
Very. It was a birthday card. Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you.
These? Yes.
Okay.
Those are from last week, but we didn't get them in time.
Okay.
The Creative Carol Designs on Etsy sent me a Grinch bag because Chelsea stole the Grinch bag. She also sent a birthday card.
First of all, I did not steal it, okay?
And then this one is puppies. It's very cute.
With candy canes on the back. Very cute. And this is her latest size. It's,
yes.
It's smaller.
Yes.
So,
we love this size.
Yeah. They fit
thank
in
you,
the
Carol.
Housewives bag. And then
you're going to have to move.
That's what this was, right?
Yes. You're going to have to move that, the big piece.
We showed this last week. Yes. All right.
So you can get to the boxes. You can do that one, yeah. Okay, and then Carol sent more project bags this week. This is her newest bag. It's really cute. It's got, like, the trees. And we'll link her shop below. But she also sent three bags for us to do a giveaway. So for the next 3 weeks, we're going to give away one of these bags. So look for that today.
Oh my goodness.
All right. This one is Halloween. The snowman.
Love the snowman.
And the
chickens.
And Carol does really amazing work. So.
Stop me with your bags. And then Denise from Dot Dot Goose Designs, she also makes project bags, but she started making these little booklets.
They aren't going to have the snaps on them anymore, she told me this morning. They're going to have
magnets
to close
them. A magnet closure. So
that's for your needle.
This is a felt heart for your needle. Then this is
the same stuff that Chelsea showed you with her nest on
it. The design board, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You can just pile your floss on here. So they're little
floss
books.
With Floss Buddy is what I think they're called.
Amazing. fabric.
So yeah, this
I love princess. This. Yes. Yeah.
All right. So thank you, Denise. Then and Erica, her shop will be linked below too.
Erica made us project bags, she said a few weeks ago. And then she designed this new one. Look at this.
I thought that she had loaded it with glitter.
So inside,
but there's two layers of vinyl. Isn't that awesome?
You thought you were going to open it
up
and
just all over.
This is awesome. Thank you so much. And she has
an Etsy shop.
An Etsy. Stars Hollow Stitchery. So she'll be linked below too.
Yep. Yeah. That's really cute. Thank you.
All right. This is from Michelle.
She sent some charts that she's ordered doubles of.
Lizzie Kate. Liberty Lane. That's one of my favorites.
Mm-hmm.
Mrs. Shelley, she sent a very cute card. Embossed.
Ah.
With these beautiful sleeves.
She said that she found them at the...
Look at how amazing they are. Filled with some radon.
And her grocery store, Publix in Florida. And she's coming to one of the Lila May retreats.
Woohoo!
So we love those. Thank you so much.
An update with that. So there was another donation that came in. So Lila May raised $1,800 in Patrick's memory for Make-A-Wish.
And it's awesome.
So thrilled.
Why don't you stick those back in the box?
Oh, yeah. And this is from Amy. Amy. She is the owner and the quilter at A Little Farm Quilts. Her card is super cute and it's got chickens on it. So you know I love it. And she found the coveted bucket stand.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much. So that'll be offered in a future giveaway.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Next time we have the next month
jar,
the new jar amount, we'll do one with the both pieces.
Okay.
Thank you so much for the gifts. Is this something?
That was from Erica. That's what she sent the bag in. So I just need it with that. Okay. Now.
Yep. On to the giveaways.
Giveaways. We had, last week, we had all of this 10 count of the new colors for Lori, mm-hmm. Lori Holt's fabric. Remember my spiel, email us in the description box below, therealhousewivesofcrossstitch@gmail.com. Email us your physical address. If you don't hear from us within 24 hours, send it again. Okay. So there were 5 winners of this. So the first one is Country Americana Stitcher, Donna White, Joanne Moore, Jennifer Leitzel, L-E-I-T-Z-E-L, and Lisa Dye. Congratulations.
Woohoo!
Number 2 was the Holiday Hoopla, and that's a With Thy Needle and Thread. And these were all given to us by Fat Quarter Shop, so thank you, Kimberly and team. We appreciate it. This goes to Karen Safransky. Congratulations. Number 3 is Merry Christmas by Collection Chalala. Pat Flynn. Number 4 is the Merry Christmas Pillow. This is an Abbey Rose Designs, and that goes to Cindy Bursalik. Number 5 is Berries and Robins. Another Madame Chantilly. That goes to Robin Prestige. Number 6 is Celebrate Christmas.
My tiered tray.
And that goes to Forensic Flosser. Number 7 is Advent Sunday. And that goes to Sherry DeYoung. Number 8 is the Early Americans All 9 Kit Not the kit. Yeah, the whole shebang.
All the tarts.
All the tarts.
No, no other supplies.
All the tarts. No supplies included. Fine print. Number 8, it goes to Lynn Bloom. Congratulations. And number 9 had two opportunities to win. The first one goes to Heather Wurzberger. Second one goes to Pat Henry. Congratulations.
Woohoo! It's all done.
Where's Hunter when you need him?
Yep.
Woo! Woo!
All right, so this week.
This week. She's just gonna organize it while I wait here and stare what she's
okay,
doing.
So first of all, we have 3 of the Holly Jolly Farm charts.
Woohoo! Woo! 3 of them. Thank you.
Also, right now, running on my Instagram and my Priscilla's Facebook page is a giveaway for two charts on each one of those. Plus, our Stitching with Housewives group has a giveaway for 1 chart. So there's 5 chances to win between those 3 places. So
you can enter them all.
The giveaway ends today. So get over there and enter those if you haven't already. Mm-hmm. And I'll be drawing the winners later today. So it gives you guys time to jump in.
This one goes until next week, obviously.
Right.
Okay, so 3 opportunities. All you have to say is, number 1, if you're interested in Holly Jolly Farm, this is the collaboration between Kathy at Hands On Design and Mom. Mom draws the chalkboards. Kathy converts them into cross stitch. Thank you, Kathy, for this. Number 2 is going to be the Eat, Sleep, Stitch, Repeat. This is Lori Holt's chart.
And one of our viewers sent that in, that she had an extra.
Yep. And that one, it looks big, but it's actually a smaller design. You can do that very easily, mm-hmm. I'd say.
The rest of these charts and books are from Fat Quarter Shop.
All right, number 3 is going to be Merry Christmas. This is the Christmas calendar by Tiny Modernist. These are small, too, so you can stitch that. Number 4, there's 2 opportunities for it, and it's Away We Go. Country Cottage Needleworks. Number 5 is Kringle and Woolard Plum Street Sampler. That one you can see a little bit back here.
Oh my gosh, I forgot to show them my quilt and my finishes.
We'll do it.
I gotta show them my quilt.
Number 6 is Winter Whirligig. You saw that one today. That is a heart and hand. Mm-hmm. Number 7, by Mom's lack of attention, this is the Christmas Alphabet by the Prairie Schooler. Hold tight. And the last giveaway, I think we're on number 9, you get the Perfect 5 quilt book and you get the Kona 365 2020 calendar. So there's 3 opportunities for that one.
Mm-hmm. And I've seen a lot of the quilts being made out of this and it looks really pretty. They look really pretty.
Yes.
So the question we want to answer is, what's your favorite Thanksgiving side dish?
Are trying to get our menu.
Yeah, we're just like,
We were thinking about a roasted cauliflower bake that's really good, but we want to see what's out there.
Mm-hmm. So tell us your favorite Thanksgiving side dish, whether you make it or whether you go eat it somewhere or whether you just want to eat it. Just tell us what your favorite is.
Yep.
And if you get your inspiration from us, tag my blog. We'd love to see your projects. And follow us on Instagram at Priscilla Blaine, at Chelsea356, Priscilla's 2000 on Facebook, and priscillas2000.blogspot.com, where you can see more of everything that we do. And we do have a lot of things in the works that are coming up that we are very excited about, and we can't wait to share it all with you guys. I finished my sweet Christmas quilt this week.
Yep, so she has the Swell Christmas. Now mm-hmm. she also has the Sweet Christmas. This is also done using the string quilt method, and we will link that video below that Fat Quarter Shop did.
But this one
tutorial.
I did a pattern where it's
the
white.
Middle strip. Yeah. The first strip that you put down is always white on this one, so then mm-hmm. when you line them up, it mm-hmm. creates this the diamond look of...
This is the backing I chose, and then I used the snowmen. I still have a lot of threads to cut off. The cats and the dogs and cat and dogs.
Yeah, we don't have any more cats.
I don't know how they know that you have a new quilt. That they all have to like take their turns laying on it, but it's been a constant somebody laying on it. So I love it. I love the colors. It's gorgeous. I'm so excited it's done.
A lot of you in our stitching with the Housewives group.
I told her, I'm like, bring all the cutting stuff. I want to make another quilt. And then I'm like, do I?
gonna make gnocchi. A lot of you are trying string quilts, the quilt as you go method, and we love seeing that because you were first time quilters or maybe experienced quilters and you'd never done it and you just wanted something easy. So we appreciate you sharing with us, and we love seeing all of that. So thank you so much. Thank you again for keeping that group positive and inspirational for people to find new ideas and sharing. We can't thank you enough. We can't.
And if you haven't joined already, it's Stitching with the Housewives on Facebook, and you just ask to join, and you have to answer a couple questions, and
then we accept you. We ask you to answer the questions just to make sure that you're not a robot, that you're not spamming, and that you're interested in the crafts that we're sharing or different crafts, just not that you're joining. So that we're not trying to keep anyone out except for people that don't belong in the group.
Right.
All right, guys, we will be back next week. Have a happy, Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
We are going to say it this time. Happy Thanksgiving. Thank you so much for sharing with us, and thank you for making this possible for us. We truly appreciate it. We will see you guys next week. Bye.